working on this big piece here, and it is fun to make. And to be doing a lot of connections, lots of different connections on here. Could you hand me a piece of that purple rain, Mike? Oh yeah, that works. Thanks. Yeah, I just pulled the stringer off of my piece. Not a perfect stringer, but I don't need much. Maybe I'll do that one more time, actually. It was pretty bad. Well, that's a little bit stronger than I thought, but... opening up this hole here, and I'm going to get it really close to this other hole, and then I'm going to coil a little bit of the purple color, which is purple rain, to close the seal. I keep reheating in the Bunsen here so I don't have to go in and out of the kiln, and I can kind of keep working on this piece for a long time and get a lot done in this hour that we have here for the live stream. Yeah, I do this all the time though, not just for live streams. I work out of the Bunsen a lot, and it helps speed up the processes of all these tube connections, because if you're, you know, doing a move and then putting it in the kiln and then doing another move, that could take probably twice as long as it takes to do it this way, so. So, I mean, really all I have to do is get it close. Then I can take this stringer that I pulled. I'm gonna give it one more reheat before I do this. So this Bunsen flame is pretty hot, just as a test to show you how warm it is. Put this little stringer in here and it bends that quickly. So kind of tells you how quickly it's heating the glass. It's much hotter than a kiln. Pretty much closed. And I'm gonna use this mini torch here to close that up the rest of the way. Actually, before I can get any air pressure, I gotta close off this bottom hole here. Gotta keep heat in that or it will crack until it gets worked in. little bit of excess material there, so use a small flame and pull a little bit off. Not like that though. Just gotta make it look a little more pretty as far as how the flow of it is, and then I'll move on to the next seal. $690? Slower. They might have a hotter outlet over there. There we go. It's looking better. Just have to touch up a little part on the top part of that drain, and then I'm gonna add, yesterday I made some discs, and I'm gonna put the discs on here and here, and then have uptakes that go into them. think I want to put this in the kiln over there for just a little bit while I prepare these discs. Thanks. So this is one of the discs here. It's not very big. It's like, I don't know, maybe an inch and a half in diameter. Looks like it's close to this tube here, but maybe 45 millimeters. Is this the kind of stream where people ask questions online and I answer them? Who knows? No? Is anyone watching it? I'm curious. I should have...
My entire stream is watching.
Oh, okay, cool. So I put a hole on the back part of this disc here, and that's where it's going to connect into the main piece here. I'm going to try the seal a couple different ways, I think. It's a bit tricky.
Yeah.
What's up?
Just a YouTube link. There's no comment section.
Oh, okay, I see. You want to rotate that in the Bunsen just for a second? I'll be right back. Gotta get the piece. That's great. You can be my kiln. Thank you. Okay.
Just don't hand me that thing.
Oh, here, can you turn? Yeah, thank you. So this is going to go on. Just trying to figure out exactly how. I'm thinking like that. Yeah, that's gonna be great. So, resume. Thank you. I'm gonna make a couple of kind of like bumps here where I'm gonna put both discs. So I got both of those ready. Now I'm gonna take that and rotate this in here and flash this. No kiln tech, although I did kiln it for a little bit, which is kind of nice because when I first put this in the Bunsen, it was at 400 degrees and that other kiln wasn't even hot yet. So I guess the seals are good because it didn't crack, so. And this is going to go here. Then I'm going to add the uptake tubes after I get the discs on. I was trying to figure out if I could do it before, but it just gets tricky as far as like length and everything. And I'd rather just have to manipulate a small tube like this than have to manipulate a disc and a tube and do a seal all at the same time. I was just trying to think of the best way. I've never done a seal exactly like this, but I've done some similar. And next step here is to open up this hole here. So I got the hole open, and then what I like to do is it's kind of like a directed seal, so it has kind of like a flap on the inside that directs the water. It forces the water flow in a certain direction. I kind of push it in at the top, but I'm going to add a little bit of material. So I'm actually going to try and pull a better stringer. It's nice to have a third hand here. Thank you. That was warm. I'm gonna cut this. Okay, so this is the fun part here. Use this piece of 4 mil. This is where I make the little flap. So this was like a little bit hot on the end. You get this glass a little bit warm. You gotta melt in all that color that I stuck on there. Heat up this little lip here, grab it, and pull it in and at an angle. It makes this little tip that's kind of like a sprinkler head.
Like what?
It's like a little sprinkler head. Just needs to be a little flap with like a little tip on there. So this tip got just a little bit funny, so fix it. Whoa, it scared me. There we go. Now it's good. Okay, I can snag that from you. So I got that ready, and then this is almost ready to stick on here. What did I do with that stringer though? Yeah, it looks really ugly right now, but it's a directed seal. So this is where I'm going to do this seal. So I'm just going to stick the top part of the seal and touch it to the top. And then there's going to be like an open spot. I'm going to leave that open. I might actually just peel a little bit of this off. So I don't need quite that much material there. Getting the angles to connect these is always tricky. I'm gonna have to go a little bit more over. That's the cool thing is you can adjust these after you stick it on, kind of bend it into place if they need these guys. Kind of want the overlapping of the circles. I kind of like the look of it. Yeah. Okay, so this is where the seal gets fun. Okay, what happened to that stringer I had? Is this it? So hard to tell. Yes, this is it. Actually, to stabilize this before I do the rest, I forgot there's an important step here. I have to do a little bridge here. I'm gonna do it right on the edge of this disc, connecting these two. Hopefully I can kind of hide it on the seams of both of these so where you could only see it at one specific angle. Looks pretty good. Give this a nice rotation in here. I need to get this all nice and happy and warm again before I connect the seal on the top part the rest of the way. You notice I've been keeping that seal warm this whole time, never really letting it get too cold because it's not really worked in all the way yet, so I don't want it to crack. Okay, this is where I will connect it, and then and puff it out and make the seal totally happy. Okay, that's all closed up. I just have to work it in now. Let me give it one more roll in here to keep it warm while that seal is going in. Getting that all worked in, make it nice and happy. No, it's not that thin, luckily. The baffle is pretty thick enough that it won't move too much. I actually first saw these baffled kind of seals like this from Ham Brushland. And I was like, that's genius. I direct the water. There we go. Oh, that seal's done. Now I gotta do the other one. How much time do we have left? Oh, cool. Get this other part ready and then prepare the disc. There, not good. The reason I hold it up is just in case any shards come off. They'll go out of the piece, not inside. What's the kiln at over here? Oh, great. Don't have to walk across the room. let that heat up for a minute. And get this other disc ready. Forgot to do the hole. Might have to do that. Got ahead of myself. A lot of steps. We only have one order. It was always kind of tricky for me to figure out how to get the hole on the backside when there's still a tube connected there. But then when I figured out, you could just pop the hole and it just kind of works. But before you can open that hole, you have to wait for this to kind of freeze up. Once this glass is frozen, then move it. Well, yeah, if it's hot, then when you try and open this, it's gonna like pry it all crazy and weird. So you have to, there's a lot of times where you have to wait for something to cool before you can do the next thing. So the glass behind where you're trying to move the glass is sturdy and can hold up, you know? Yeah. Need more stringer. Should have pulled a bunch of this, but didn't. feeling I'm going to need a couple of these, so I'm just going to pull a couple. What's up?
Not doing any more tanks, just turn yourself a piece.
Don't have to, because now I have a hot kiln. It's nice. No more pulling stringers off a piece, yeah. Funny. I've done that a lot, though. I'm kind of like one of those workers that doesn't have everything ready, but I can like get it ready while I'm working.
That's the way to do it. Three things at once.
Sometimes I can plan stuff farther ahead, but when I'm making a new piece like this, it's like the first time I'm making it, so it's harder to plan everything.
Yeah.
Gotta see it in person, I guess.
Yeah, gotta see this in person.
Come on, I gotta get one more thing out of here. Okay. We'll at least get this other disc on. Symmetry is the key here. That looks pretty good.
Yeah. So it's not attached at the half like right here.
That's insane.
Well, I will connect it here in a second. I'm just trying to get it all centered into place. I want all the negative space to match.
Yeah.
another bridge. I think it needs one more functional disc on the back part. That would look cool, right? Just kind of fill it out.
Just keep adding.
Keep adding, yeah. Totally. And I'm gonna connect tubes from these discs here. They'll go down into here. So probably from right here, because that's the low point, and then just go and then and then I'm gonna put like horns all over it, just like covered in horns. Kind of like a old school, new school mashup for me, because I used to do a lot of horns and I haven't really done them very much for a while. Okay. I think that that's good. I might want to go in just a little more, actually. Okay. You can actually kind of look inside the seal and see if it's all the way worked in, which is kind of nice. I think I actually need to go in on the other one a little bit. It hasn't cracked or anything, but I don't want it to, so. Okay. That's better. So both seals are somewhat happy, it seems. They're all melted in. There's no ridges anywhere on the inside, no acute angles, hopefully.
That's
it away here. Cool. Yeah.
Sick.
Thanks. Thank you all for watching. It was awesome.